See that? It's not for those who are easily disturbed. So, don't be disturbed. Or be children. Oh boy. We are in for one tonight. Individuals suffering from anxiety or depression may not have a positive experience playing this game. Oh boy. Would you like to review detailed warnings? I will be fine. I know enough about this game that I know why this game has the tags that it has. Let's just wait. Okay, wait. That's yes. There's no. Okay. We're gonna be fine. Well, I'm gonna be fine, but we'll see. Let's find ourselves a webcam. 'Cause yeah. I don't know how long it takes for this game to, get crazy, but yeah. We'll put ourselves on the right. If we gotta move, we will move. We will. Hi. Hey everybody, I am Somebody Nor, and tonight it is Saturday, and I play free games on Saturday. Tonight's free game is the free with PlayStation Plus essential title, Doki Doki Literature Club Plus. I have no idea what the plus means. I've watched a little bit of this get played to the point where I know about it getting crazy. But yeah, I don't know what the plus means other than maybe it has to have like different mechanics to work with the game system. So yeah. By playing Doki Doki Literature Club, you agree to have noted the game's age rating and region, and it could be disturbing. Yeah, I agree. Let's go. All right. Yeah, this game is free with PlayStation Plus. And I really don't know what to expect exactly, but I know this game is not what it seems on its face. I just don't know how long it takes for it to get crazy. Auto forward time. Don't think we have anything we need to change. And nothing seems like it needs to be changed. But let's get into this, see how it goes. 'Cause yeah, I think at its core, at least for the start, it just comes off as visual novel dating sim kind of thing. So yeah, let's go. Oh my god, why is my name so long? Why does my name have to be so long? There we go. That'll have to do. That's it. Okay. Hey! I see an annoying girl running toward me. Distance, waving her arms in the air like she's totally oblivious to any attention she might draw to herself. That girl is Sayori, my neighbor and good friend since we were children. You know, the kind of friend you'd never see yourself making today, but it just kind of works out because you've known each other for so long. We used to walk to school together on days like this, but starting around high school, she would oversleep more and more frequently, and I would get tired of waiting up. But if she's gonna chase after me like this, I almost feel better off running away. However, I just sigh and idle in front of the crosswalk and let Sayori catch up to me.
I overslept again. But I caught you this time.
Maybe, but only because I decided to stop and wait for you.
You say that like you were thinking about ignoring me.
It's with, like, the finger thing. Sheesh.
That's mean, Essen.
Well, if people stare at you for acting weird, then I don't want them to think we're a couple or something.
Fine. But you did wait for me, after all. I guess you don't have it in you to be mean, even if you want to.
Whatever you say, Sayori. We cross the street together and make our way to school. As we draw near, the streets become increasingly speckled with students making their daily commute.
By the way, Sen, have you decided on a club to join yet?
A club?
I told you,
I'm really not interested in joining any clubs.
I haven't been looking either. That's not true. You told me you'd join a club this year.
Did I?
I'm sure it's
possible in one of our many conversations where I dismissively go along with whatever she's going on about. Sayori likes to worry a little too much about me, when I'm perfectly content just getting by on average, while spending my time on games and anime.
I was talking about how I'm worried that you won't learn how to socialize or have any skills before college. Your happiness is really important to me, you know? I know you're happy now, but I'd die at the thought of you becoming a neet in a few years because you're not used to the real world. You trust me, right? Don't make me keep worrying about you.
All right. I'll look at a few clubs if that makes you happy. No promises, though.
Will you at least promise me you'll try a little?
Yeah, I guess I'll promise you that.
Yay!
Why do I let myself get lectured by such a carefree girl? More than that, I'm surprised. I even let myself relent to her. I guess seeing her worry so much about me makes me want to ease her mind at least a little bit, even if she does exaggerate everything inside of her head. School day is as ordinary as ever, and it's over before I know it. After I pack up my things, I stare blankly at the wall, looking for an ounce of motivation. Clubs. Sayori wants me to check out some clubs. I guess I have no choice but to start with the anime club.
Hello,
Sayori. Sayori must have come into the classroom while I was spacing out. I look around and realize that I'm the only one left in the classroom.
I thought I'd catch you coming out of the classroom, but I saw you were just sitting here spacing out, so I came in. Honestly, you're even worse than me sometimes. I'm impressed.
You don't need to wait up for me, and if it's gonna make you late to your own club, you don't need to wait. It's gonna make you late.
Well, I thought you might need some encouragement, so I thought, you know...
Know what?
Well, that you could come join my club.
Sayori?
Yeah.
There is no way I'm going to your club.
Me?
Sayori is vice president of the literature club. Not that I was ever aware that she had any interest in literature. In fact, I'm 99% sure she only did it because she thought it would be fun to help start a new club. Since she was the first one to show interest after the one who proposed the club, she inherited the title Vice President. That said, my interest in literature is guaranteed to be even less. Yeah, I'm going to the anime club. Come on, please? Why do you care so much anyway?
Well, I kind of told the club yesterday I would bring in a new member. And Natsuki made cupcakes and everything.
Don't make promises you can't keep. I can't tell if Sayori is really that much of an airhead, or if she's so cunning as to plan all this out. I let out a long sigh. Fine, I'll stop by for a cupcake, okay?
Yes, let's go!
And thus, today marks the day I sold my soul for a cupcake. I dejectedly follow Sayori across the school and upstairs, a section of the school I rarely visit. Sayori, full of energy, swings open the classroom door.
Everyone, new member is here.
I told you, don't call me a new member. I glance around the room.
Welcome to the Literature Club. It's a pleasure meeting you. Sayori always says nice things about you. Seriously, you brought a boy? Way to kill the atmosphere. SN, what a surprise! What a nice surprise! Welcome to the club!
Why does she... All words escape me in this situation. This club is full of incredibly cute girls.
What are you looking at? If you want to say something, say it.
Sorry.
Natsuki.
The girl with the sour attitude, whose name is apparently Natsuki, is the one I don't recognize. Her small figure makes her look like a first-year student. She's also the one who made cupcakes, according to Sayori.
You can just ignore her when she gets moody.
Sayori says that quietly into my ear, then turns back towards the other girls.
Anyway, this is Natsuki, always full of energy. And this is Yuri, the smartest in the club. Don't say things like that.
Yuri, who appears comparably more mature and timid, seems to have a hard time keeping up with people like Sayori and Natsuki. Well, it's nice to meet both of you.
And sounds like you've already met Monika, is that right?
Allie, just so you know, this game is not at all, like, I know what the game looks like, but I also know where this game goes, so know that this game goes off the rails at a certain point. But I do appreciate you stopping in and being able to, you know, look in on things. But yeah, this game goes a little... Let me put it this way. There is a good reason why PlayStation would want to put this game in its October selections. If you don't know anything about this game, you're in for a ride.
That's right. It's great to see you again, SN. Monika smiles sweetly.
If you're not familiar with it, and you did come in a little bit late, at the very beginning, before the game started proper, it did give warnings that it is not for the faint of heart, and it does have warnings. Yeah, don't worry, right now, I'm pretty I haven't played it original. I haven't played the original run, or the original version. But I watched a little bit enough to know, and through general video game cultural osmosis, I know where the game goes. I just have no idea how long it takes to get to the off the rails that it goes. But hello, how would you prefer to be referred to? 07? 09? Hello? First time. But yeah, we're just gonna try to get through this. I know that it... 00? Alright, 00. Hello, 00. We're just gonna try to take this as casual. As far as I know, the initial playthrough more or less runs like a standard dating sim, like high school dating sim, virtual or visual novel. So we're just going to try to roll with it, and then I know that it gets weird later, but we're just going to try to have some fun with it and not get traumatized eventually. We do know each other. Well, we rarely talked, but we were in the same class last year. That is weird, though. It's like Monica knows us ahead of time. That is a little weird. But if you're late coming in, let me quickly bring you up to speed. The girl on the left is pretty much the childhood friend archetype, and where she's known the main character since growing up, that sort of thing. And we've just been introduced to the other members of the literature club. One is clearly like is a younger look, but she's like the what's it? Tsundere? The standoffish, but probably likes the person more than they put on. And yeah, these people are very like archetypes, but that's kind of how the game works. Monica was probably the most popular girl in class. Smart, beautiful, athletic. Basically completely out of my league. So having her smile at me so genuinely feels a little... You too, Monica? Come sit down, SN. We made room for you at the table, so you can sit next to me or Monica. I'll get the cupcakes. Hey! I made them. I'll get them. Sorry. I got a little too excited. She keeps doing like this thing with her hand. Then, how about I make some tea as well? The girls have a few desks arranged to form a table. As Sayori mentioned, it's been widened. So, there's one space next to Monica, one space next to Sayori. I like the one in purple. To be completely honest, I like the one in purple. But given the option, we either go sit next to Monica or we sit next to Sayori. Sayori has been our, like, childhood friend, so I suppose we'd sit there, given the option. Natsuki and Yuri walk over to the corner of the room, where Natsuki grabs a wrapped tray and Yuri opens the closet. Still feeling awkward, I take a seat next to Sayori. Natsuki proudly marches back to the table, tray in hand. Okay, are you ready? Ta-da! Whoa! Natsuki lifts the foil off the tray to reveal a dozen white fluffy cupcakes, decorated to look like little cats. The whiskers are drawn with icing, the little pieces of chocolate were used to make ears. So cute! I had no idea you were so good at baking, Natsuki. Well, you know, just hurry and take one. Sayori grabs one first, then Monica. I follow. It's delicious! Sayori talks with her mouth full, and has already managed to get icing on her face. Oh, hey, Tennille. How goes the things? I turn the cupcake around in my fingers, looking for the best angle to take a bite. Natsuki is quiet, I can't help but notice her sneaking glances in my direction. Is she waiting for me to take a bite? I finally bite down. The icing is sweet, full of flavor. I wonder if she made it herself. This is Doki Doki Literature Club. I guess technically Doki Doki Literature Club Plus, but... Thank you. Thank you. Yeah, this is Doki Doki Literature Club Plus, and at least for the first playthrough, I think, it just runs like a standard, like, dating sim visual novel. But it also eventually gets very... I don't want to spoil it, because I know enough about it to know that it gets very... But at the very least, we're just going to try to have some fun with it. And, yeah. Yeah, if you're not familiar with it, just know that it did have tags before the game that really got stow-arted that... Yeah, buckle up, because when the game goes off the rails, it ends up going way off the rails. It uses the framework of a cutesy visual novel to basically get you off guard. That's the best way I can explain it without really ruining the surprise. I wonder if she made it herself. This is really good. Thank you, Natsuki. Why are you thanking me? It's not like I... Haven't I heard this somewhere before? Made them for you or anything? I thought you technically did. Sayori said... Well, maybe. But not for you. No, you, dummy. Yeah, she is like 100% like Tsundere archetype. All right. I give up on Natsuki's weird logic and dismiss the conversation. Yuri returns to the table carrying a tea set. She carefully places a teacup in front of each of us before setting down the teapot next to the cupcake tray. You keep a whole tea set in this classroom? Don't worry, the teachers gave us permission. After all, doesn't a hot cup of tea help you enjoy a good book? I guess. Don't let yourself get intimidated. Yuri's just trying to impress you. That's not... Insulted, Yuri looks away.
I mean, that, you know...
I believe you. Well, tea and reading might not be the pastime for me, but I at least enjoy tea.
I'm glad.
Yuri faintly smiles to herself in relief. Monica raises an eyebrow, then smiles at me.
So, what made you consider the Literature Club?
I was afraid of this question. Something tells me I shouldn't tell Monica that I was practically dragged here by Sayori. Well, I haven't joined any clubs yet, and Sayori seemed really happy here, so...
That's okay, don't be embarrassed. We'll make sure you feel right at home, okay? As president of the Literature Club, it's my duty to make the club fun and exciting for everyone.
Monica, I'm surprised. How come you decided to start your own club? You could probably be a board member of any of the major clubs. Weren't you the leader of the debate club last year?
Well, you know, to be honest, I can't stand all of the politics around the major clubs. It feels like nothing but arguing about the budget and publicity and how to prepare for events. I'd much rather take something I personally enjoy and make something special out of it. And it encourages others to get into literature, then I'm fulfilling that dream. Monica really is a great leader.
Yuri also nods in agreement. Then I'm surprised there aren't more people in the club yet. It must be hard to start a new club.
You could put it that way. Not many people are very interested in putting out all the effort to start something brand new. Especially when something that doesn't grab your attention, like literature. You have to work hard to convince people that you're both fun and worthwhile. But it makes school events like the festivals that much more important. I'm confident we can really grow this club before we graduate. Right, everyone? Yeah! We'll do our best. But you know it.
Everyone enthusiastically agrees. Such different girls, all interested in the same goal. Monica must have worked really hard to find these three. Maybe that's why they were all so delighted at the idea of a new member joining. Though I still don't really know if I can keep up with their level of enthusiasm about literature.
So, SN, what kind of things do you like to read?
Well, considering how little I've read in the past few years, I don't really have a good way of answering that. Manga? I mutter quietly to myself, half joking. Natsuki's head suddenly perks up. Looks like she wants to say something, but she keeps quiet.
Not much of a reader, I guess.
Well, that can change. What am I saying? I spoke without thinking after seeing Yuri's sad smile. Anyway, what about you, Yuri?
Well, let's see.
Yuri traces the rim of her teacup with her finger.
My favorites are usually novels that build deep and complex fantasy worlds. The level of creativity and craftsmanship behind them is amazing to me. Telling a good story in such a foreign world is equally impressive.
Yuri goes on, clearly passionate about her reading. She seemed so reserved and timid since the moment I walked in, but it's obvious by the way her eyes light up that she finds her comfort in the world of books, not people.
But, you know, I like a lot of things. Stories with deep psychological elements usually immerse me as well. Isn't it amazing how a writer can be so deliberate? A writer can so deliberately take advantage of your own lack of imagination to completely throw you for a loop? Anyway, I've been reading a lot of horror lately.
Oh, I read a horror book once. I desperately grasp something I can relate to at the minimal level. At this rate, Yuri might as well be having a conversation with a rock.
Really? I wouldn't have expected that, Yuri. For someone as gentle as you? I guess you could say that. But if a story makes me think, or takes me to another world, then I really can't put it down. Surreal horror is often very successful at changing the way you look at the world, if only for a brief moment. Ugh, I hate horror. Oh, why's that? Well, I just...
Natsuki's eyes dart over to me for a split second.
Never mind. That's right. You usually like to write about cute things, don't you, Natsuki? What? What gives you that idea? You left a piece of scrap paper behind at the last club meeting. Looked like you were working on a poem called... Don't say it out loud! And give it that back! Fine. Your cupcakes, your poems... Everything you do is as cute as you are.
Sayori sidles up behind Natsuki and puts her hand on her shoulders.
I am not cute!
Natsuki, you write your own poems?
Well, I guess sometimes. Why do you care?
I think that's impressive. But why don't you share them sometime?
No!
Natsuki averts her eyes.
You wouldn't like them.
Not very confident writer yet?
I understand how Natsuki feels. Sharing that level of writing takes more than just confidence. The truest form of writing is writing to oneself. You must be willing to open up to your readers, exposing your vulnerabilities and showing even the deepest reaches of your heart.
Yeah, it... Knowing where it's going, I just don't know how long it takes to get to the twist. But yeah, it spends long enough, at least, you know, building the world in this sort of scenario.
You have writing experience too, Yuri? Maybe if you share some of your work, you can set an example to help Natsuki feel comfortable enough to share hers.
I guess it's the same for Yuri.
I wanted to read everyone's poems.
We all sit in silence for a moment.
Okay. I have an idea, everyone.
Natsuki and Yuri look quizzically at Monika.
Let's all go home and write a poem of our own. Then, next time we meet, we'll all share them with each other. That way, everyone is even.
Ellie, you got that?
Yes, I can get it. Let's do it. Now, that we have a new member, I think it'll help us get a little more comfortable with each other. Strengthen the bond of the club. Isn't that right, Asen?
Monika smiles warmly at me once again. Hold on, there's still one problem.
Oh, what's that?
Now that we're back to the original topic of joining the club, I bluntly come forth with what's been on my mind the entire time. I never said I would join the club. Sayori may have convinced me to stop by, but I never made any decision. I still have other clubs to look at, and, I lose my train of thought. All four girls stare back at me with dejected eyes.
But... I'm sorry, I thought... Listen.
You all... I'm defenseless against these girls. How am I supposed to make a clear-headed decision when it's like this? That is, if writing poems is the price I need to pay in order to spend every day with these beautiful girls. Right. Okay. I've decided then. I'll join the literature club. One by one, the girls' eyes light up.
Yes, I'm so happy.
Sayori wraps her arms around me, jumping up and down. Hey!
You really did scare me for a moment. If you really just came for the cupcakes, I would be super pissed. Then, that makes it official. Welcome to the literature club.
Thanks, I guess.
Okay, everyone. I think with that, we can officially end today's meeting on a good note. Everyone remember tonight's assignment. Write a poem to bring to the next meeting so we can all share.
Monika looks over at me once more.
Listen, I look forward to seeing how you express yourself.
Yeah. Can I really impress the class star Monica with my mediocre writing skills? I already feel the anxiety welling up inside me. Meanwhile, the girls continue to chit-chat as Yuri and Natsuki clean up their food.
Hey, Asen, since you're already here, do you want to walk home together?
That's right. Sayori and I never walk home together anymore because she's always stayed after school for clubs. Sure, might as well.
Yay!
With that, the two of us depart the club room and make our way home. The whole way, my mind wanders back and forth between the four girls. Sayori, Natsuki, Yuri, and of course, Monica. Will I really be happy spending every day after school in the literature club? Perhaps I'll have a chance to grow closer to one of these girls. Alright. I'll just need to make the most of my circumstances, and I'm sure good fortune will find me. And I guess that starts with writing a poem tonight. Time to write a poem. Pick words you think your favorite club member will like. Something good might happen with whoever likes a poem most. Ooh. Okay, so we've got to pick something that someone will like, but, like, I mean, Fluffy? Allie, help. What do I choose? Look, I don't know which ones are implying who, necessarily. Like, you know what? Let's go with Fluffy. I don't know. Oh! Apparently, Natsuki likes Fluffy. Hello, Joyce. How are things? I don't know. Fluffy, let's also go with Bouncy. Oh, it's her again. Let's see. Lollipop, Ribbon, Disaster. I mean, Friends is probably, the childhood friend, right? I know enough about the game to know that when it goes off the rails, it ends up going way off the rails. But I don't know how long it takes to reach that point. I'm hoping it happens within, like, the couple of hours that the stream is gonna go. But yeah, I know the game when it goes. Oh boy, does it ever go. Thanks for the warning. Oh, apparently I took so long that I earned Poetry Slam trophy. You know, I'll go with Ribbon. Oh, it's her again. We're starting to lean towards Natsuki. Whether intentional or otherwise. Whisper? Oh. Like, she's the one that keeps jumping up every time I pick a thing. Starscape? Oh! And she jumped. Let's see. Imagination. Yay. Effulgent? Effulgent. Joy? Oh, yeah, I don't think we'd had her at all. That's what... I don't know effulgent. That's on me. Like, that's me being confused, too. Let's see. Vivid. Oh, it's her again. Headphones? Headphones. Oh, there's her again. Like, I get that she's like very tsundere. That's her archetype for sure. Let's see. Blanket? Oh. There we are again. Like, most of these have been her in the middle. What? Natsuki. Memories. Yeah, there you go. Tsundere usually means they pretend to hate you more than they actually do. That's how that archetype works. Like, they pretend to hate the person, but they actually like them. Like, that sort of thing. Give or take. Boop. Boop. Oh. Okay. I don't... These are... Wow, a lot of these are not pleasant. Peaceful. There we go. Let's see. Calm. Alright. Got five more to choose. Daydream. There we are. Candy. I don't know. Yeah, I know when it gets going with the crazy. It, yeah. I watched a little bit of it get played, and I don't have any idea when that happens in the course of the game, but yeah, it was definitely earning its horror tag. Puppy. Clumsy. Suicide. Jesus. Ocean. Fun. I think that we ended up picking the friend. Hi, Innocent. Glad to see you didn't run away on us. Don't worry. This might be a little strange for me, but I at least kept my word. Well, I'm back at the Literature Club. I was... Yeah, I know that it gets... Yeah. I was the last to come in, so everyone else is already hanging out. Thanks for keeping your promises, and I hope this isn't too overwhelming of a commitment for you. Making you dive headfirst into the literature when you're not accustomed to it. Oh, come on! Lucky deserves any slack. Sayori told me you didn't even want to join any clubs this year. And last year, too. I don't know if you planned to just come here and hang out or what. But if you don't take us seriously, then you won't see the end of it. Natsuki, you certainly have a big mouth for someone who keeps her manga collection in the club room. Natsuki finds herself stuck between saying Monica and manga. Manga is literature! Swiftly defeated, Natsuki plops back into her seat. Don't worry, guys. Ezen always gives best as long as he's having fun. Helps me with busy work without even asking. Like cooking, cleaning my room. How dependable. Sayori, that's because your room is so messy it's distracting. And you almost set your house on fire once. Is that so? You two are really good friends, aren't you? I might be a little jealous. How come you and SN became good friends, too? Or how come you two can become good friends?
Sayori?
Hmm?
ellipsis. As usual, Sayori seems oblivious to the weird situation she's put in front of me.
Yuri even brought you something today, you know? Wait, Sayori!
Me?
No, not really. Don't be shy. It's really nothing.
What is it?
Never mind. Sayori made it sound like a big deal when it's not. What do I do? Sorry, Yuri, I wasn't thinking.
Because it means it's up to me to rescue this situation. Hey, don't worry about it. First of all, I wasn't expecting anything in the first place. So a nice gesture from you is a pleasant surprise. It'll make me happy no matter what.
Is that so?
Yeah. I won't make it a big deal if you don't want it to be.
Alright. Well, here.
Yuri reaches into her bag and pulls out a book.
I didn't want you to feel left out. So I picked out a book that I thought you might enjoy. It's a real short read, so it should keep your attention, even if you don't usually read. And we could, you know, discuss it if you wanted.
How is this girl accidentally being so cute? She even picked out a book she thinks I'll like, despite me not reading much. Yuri, thank you. I'll definitely read this. I enthusiastically take the book.
Phew. Well, you can read it at your own pace. I look forward to hearing what you think.
Now that everyone's settled in, I expect Monika to kick off some scheduled activities for the club. But that doesn't seem to be the case. Sayori and Monika are having a cheery conversation in the corner. Yuri's face is already buried in a book. I can't help but notice her intense expression, like she was waiting for this chance. Meanwhile, Natsuki is rummaging around in the closet. Man, looks like no one wants to be bothered today. I slump down the nearest desk. How am I supposed to occupy myself with something literature-related by myself like this? I guess I could always read some of the book Yuri gave me. But I'm feeling a little too tired to read. I could probably fall asleep right now. I close my eyes and listen up and end up listening in on Sayori's conversation with Monika.
We're probably gonna seem really lame compared to all the other clubs, though. Well, we can't give up. Festival's our chance to show everyone that what literature's all about. The problem is, the idea of a literature club sounds too dense and intellectual. But it's not like that at all, you know? We need a way of showing that to everyone. Something that speaks to their creative minds. That doesn't solve the problem, though. What do you mean? Even if we come up with the most fun thing ever, nobody will come in the first place if it's a literature event. So it's more important to figure out how to get people to show up in the first place, you know? And after they come, we can do the thing to speak to their creative minds.
What's this? Sayori is taking this really seriously. It's rare to hear her deliberating like this.
Huh? That's a good point. In that case, do you think food will do the trick? What kind? Well, I guess we could... Cupcakes! Good thinking. Natsuki would love to do that. You're right. Natsuki makes the best cupcakes. That works out perfectly. That wasn't why you suggested it. Cupcakes speak to my creative tummy. cupcakes it is then. I'm hungry. Anyway, we need to work out the details of the event itself.
I find myself smiling. In the end, Sayori is still her usual self. But therein lies the unexpected reason I admire her. Unlike me, who has trouble finding any motivation at all, Sayori can put her mind to things and make them come to life. I suppose that's why I end up letting her get on my case about things. I can't help but wonder what it would be like to see the world through her eyes.
Ah!
I opened my eyes to find Sayori's face filling my vision. I nearly fall out of my chair.
It was like, yeah, that was awfully close.
That was a real close-up.
Sorry. Wait. Actually, I'm not sorry at all. It's your fault for sleeping like that. This isn't napping club.
Does our school have a napping club? Yeah, I know that gets worse.
You're staying up late again, aren't you? Now that you're in a club, you're gonna have less time for anime, you know? You need to get used to it.
Don't say that out loud, or don't say that so loud. I glance over my shoulder to see if Monica overheard.
It's true, though.
Yeah. I know. You're always looking out for me, Sayori.
That's what I do best.
That's a problem. What about you? You look out for me better than you look out for yourself. You're still oversleeping every day, aren't you?
Not every day.
That's not very convincing. How many days this past week have you gotten up on time?
It's a secret!
I mean, it's been a while since I've done a voices game. So, I'm not getting as crazy with it as I have in the past, but, you know, I'm trying to have fun with it. I knew it.
Come on! At least give me the benefit of the doubt.
I can't even do that. Look, Sayori, it's written all over you.
Eh?
Sayori glances around at herself.
How is it written all over me?
She glances at herself. You were clearly in a rush this morning. Look, your hair is sticking out around here. I run my fingertips down the side of Sayori's hair, trying to straighten it out. And you really need a brush for this.
My hair is really hard to get right.
I won't fall for that. There's more than just your hair. Look, your bow isn't straight either. And there's a toothpaste stain on your collar right there. I try to wipe off the stain with my finger.
But nobody would even notice that.
Of course they would. Nobody's going to tell you about it because they don't want to embarrass you. It's space out with dialogue. Fortunately, I don't really care about that.
Hey, you meanie.
And you don't even keep your blazer buttoned up. Seriously, Sayori, why do you think you don't have a boyfriend yet?
That's super mean.
Sorry, but you'll thank me later. I start to button her blazer from the bottom. Once you see how much better it looks, you'll change your mind. This is awkward. Yeah, this is awkward.
This is so funny.
What is?
Well, I was just thinking how weird it is to have a friend who does these kinds of things.
Eh? Just don't say that. You'll make me feel weird about it, stupid.
It's okay, though. I'm happy we're like this. Aren't you?
I guess.
Hey, be careful. The button might come off.
Why is this one so hard to close? I struggle to close the button near her chest. Does this thing even fit you properly?
It did when I bought it.
I'll be here, struggling my way through this, because it's only getting more uncomfortable. Sigh. If you ever buttoned it, you would have noticed sooner that it doesn't fit you anymore. What are you smiling about?
It means my boobs got bigger again.
Don't say that out loud. Anyway, you look much better now, so... Why does it feel strange to see Sayori's blazer buttoned up like this?
It's so stuffy. It's not worth it at all.
Sayori hastily unbuttons her blazer once more.
Phew. So much better.
Sayori puts her arms out and twirls around.
So, if I keep it unbuttoned, then I won't get a boyfriend, right?
What kind of logic is that? And why are you saying that like it's a good thing?
Because if I had a boyfriend, then he wouldn't even let me... Then he wouldn't even let you do things like this. And you take better care of me than anyone else would anyway. So, that's why I'm keeping it unbuttoned.
Stop saying all these embarrassing things.
Eh? I didn't say anything embarrassing.
Jeez. Well, anyway, just focus on trying to wake up a little earlier.
Only... if you focus on going to bed earlier.
Fine, fine. It's a deal.
I guess we really are better at taking care of each other than we are at taking care of ourselves.
Yeah, I guess so, huh?
So, maybe you should come wake me up in the morning.
You're doing it again, Sayori.
I was joking that time.
Man, it is impossible to tell with you sometimes.
Okay, everyone.
Eh? Monica suddenly calls out.
Why don't we share the poems we wrote now? Yay! Listen, I can't wait to read yours.
Yeah, same. I fail to sound enthusiastic, but Sayori still trots away to retrieve her poem.
By the way, did you remember to write a poem last night?
Yeah. My relaxation ends. I can't believe I agreed to do something so embarrassing. I couldn't really find much inspiration, since I've never really done this before.
Well, now that everyone's ready, why don't you find someone to share it with? I can't wait.
Sayori and Monica enthusiastically pull out their poems. Sayori's is on a wrinkled sheet of loose leaf torn from a spiral notebook. On the other hand, Monica wrote hers in a composition notebook. I can already see Monica's pristine handwriting from where I sit. Natsuki and Yuri reluctantly comply as well, reaching into their bags. I do the same myself. Who should I show the poem to first? I mean, clearly it was Sayori that, like, her little animated doodad jumped the most, right? So hypothetically, she's gonna like it the most. Let's just go with that. I'm definitely most comfortable sharing it with Sayori first. She's my good friend, after all.
Goodness! This is so good, SN.
Eh?
I love it. I had no idea you're such a good writer.
Sayori, you must be seriously overreacting. I am not a good writer at all. I honestly have no idea what I'm doing.
Well, maybe that's why. Because I have no idea what I like either.
Jeez. I'm sure Yuri's opinion has a little more... Yuri's opinion has to be a little more constructive than this. Maybe even Natsuki's. Are you sure you don't just like it because I wrote it?
Eh?
Well,
I'm sure that's part of it. I think I understand you better than a lot of people, you know? So, when I read your poem, it's not just a poem. It's an SN poem. And that makes it feel extra special. Like, I can feel your feelings in it.
Sayori hugs the sheet against her chest. That's a little weird, but okay. You're so weird, Sayori.
I'm really happy. Just that you wrote one. It reminds me that you're really part of the club now.
Not to mention the fact that I'm standing in front of you in the club room. Well, of course. I'm not really into it yet, but that doesn't mean I'll break my promise.
See? It's like I said before, Asen. Deep down, you're not selfish at all, you know? Trying new things like this for other people, that's something that only good people do.
Thanks, Sayori. I'm not sure if Sayori sees the full picture of my motive here. Then again, I can't deny she's part of the reason I joined. Knowing how much this means to her and all.
Yeah? And I'm gonna make sure there's lots of fun here, okay? That way, that will be my way of thanking you.
Alright. I'm gonna hold you to that, then.
Yay! Now, you'll read my poem too, right? Don't worry, I'm really bad at this.
Well, we'll see about that. Dear Sunshine, the way you glow through my blinds in the morning, it makes me feel like you missed me. Kissing my forehead to help me out of bed, making me rub the sleepy from my eyes. Are you asking me to come out and play? Are you trusting me to wish away the rainy day? I look above, the sky is blue. It's a secret, but I trust you too. If it wasn't for you, I could sleep forever. But I'm not mad. I want breakfast. Sure. Sayori. This is just a guess, but... did you wait until this morning to write this?
No. Just a little bit.
You can't answer just a little bit to a yes or no question.
I forgot to do it last night.
Well, at least that makes me feel a little better about myself.
Don't be mean. I still tried my best.
Yeah. I didn't mean to say that it was a bad poem. It came out nice, or how should I put it? It sounds just like you.
Really?
Yeah. Especially that last line.
I made eggs and toast!
Even though you were late to school.
It's bad to skip breakfast. I get all cranky.
Well, I guess there's no point in arguing. Anyway, thanks for showing me.
It's so much fun! Monica's the best!
Yeah.
But next time, I won't forget. I'm going to write the best poem ever.
Well, I guess I look forward to it. Who should I show my poem to next? I mean, Natsuki was the other one that, like, jumped the most when we were writing it, right? While I am curious to see what's going on with Yuri, let's see what Natsuki's up to.
Ellipses. Well, it's about what I expected from someone like you.
That's a little blunt.
Well, excuse me. It's not like I said it was bad. Just does not evoke any emotions. So basically, it's not cute enough.
It's not cute enough for your tastes.
Do you want to get smacked?
I'll pass.
Sigh. Well, anyway, I guess I need to show you mine. Not that you'll like it.
Eagles can fly. Monkeys can climb. Crickets can leap. Horses can race. Owls can seek. Cheetahs can run. Eagles can fly. People can try. But that's about it. I like how the music changed while we're reading her poem. Yeah, I like how the music changed. That was pretty good.
Yeah. I told you you weren't gonna like it.
I like it.
What? Just be honest.
I am. Why are you so convinced that I wouldn't like it?
Well, because everyone in high school thinks that writing has to be all sophisticated and stuff. So people don't even take my writing seriously.
But isn't the point of poems for people to express themselves? Your writing style wouldn't make your message any less valid.
Yes, exactly! I like when it's easy to read, but it hits you hard. Like in this poem. Seeing everyone around you doing great things can be really disheartening. So I decided to write about it.
Yeah, I understand.
And the other nice thing about simple writing is that it puts more weight on the wordplay. Like, I set up for the rhyme at the end, but then made it fall flat on purpose. Helps bring out the feeling in the last line.
So you did? I guess it went in. I guess more went into that than I realized.
That's what it means to be a pro. I'm glad you learned something. Didn't expect for that from the youngest one here, did you?
Yeah, guess not. I decide to humor her with the last comment. I really don't care how old everyone is. But if Natsuki is feeling proud, then I won't take that away from her. I mean, let's see what Yuri wrote. Yeah, we'll just go down the line. Yuri stares at the poem. A minute passes, more than enough time for her to finish reading.
Oh, sorry. I forgot to start speaking.
It's fine. Don't force yourself.
I'm not. I just need to put my thoughts into words. Hold on. Okay. This is your first time writing a poem, right?
Yeah? Why do you ask?
I'm just making sure. I guess that it might be after reading through it.
Wow! Sheesh. So it's that bad.
No. Did I just raise my voice? I'm so sorry.
Yuri buries her face in her hands. I couldn't help but notice that it's been several minutes and we really haven't gotten anywhere. It might take Yuri a while to get used to new people. It's fine. I really didn't notice. What were you saying?
Right. It's just... There's specific writing habits that are usually typical of new writers. And having been through them myself, I kind of learned to pick up on them. I think the most noticeable thing is recognizing in new writers is that they try to make their style very deliberate. In other words, they tend to pick a writing style separate from the topic matter, and then form-fit the two together. The end result is that both the style and the expressiveness are weakened.
Once Yuri finds a train of thought, it's as if her demeanor totally changes. Her stammering is completely gone, and she sounds like an expert.
Of course, it's not something you can be blamed for. There are so many different skills and techniques that go into writing even a simple poem. Not just finding them and building them, but getting them to work together is probably the most challenging part. It might take you some time, but it all comes with practice and learning by example and trying new things. I also hope that everyone else in the club gives you valuable feedback. Natsuki can be a little biased, though.
Biased how?
Well... Never mind. I shouldn't be talking about people like that. Sorry.
It's fine. I'm not sure if Yuri is apologizing to herself, to me, or to Natsuki. Do you mind if I read your poem now?
Please do. I love to share my thought process behind it.
Yuri smiles dreamily, as if it's a rare opportunity for her. Which itself is kind of funny. After all, isn't this supposed to be a literature club? Ghost Under the Light. The tendrils of my hair illuminate beneath the amber glow. Why can't I read? It must be this one, the last remaining streetlight to have withstood the test of time, the last yet to be replaced by the sickening blue-green hue of the future. I bathe. Calm, breathing, air of the present, but living in the past. The light flickers. I flicker back. Interesting. I think that's more deep than I am.
I'm sorry, I have such terrible handwriting.
What? I wasn't thinking that at all. I did kind of have difficulty reading some of that, but whatever.
You took an awful long time to read.
I just... don't read script very often. I actually think your handwriting is pretty.
Huh? That's a relief.
Also, I like the poem. Even though it's short, it was really descriptive.
It wasn't too short. I usually like write longer poems.
Not at all.
Glad you liked it. I'll be honest. Since it's our first time sharing, I want to write something a little more mild. Something easy to digest, I suppose.
Are you into ghosts, Yuri?
Huh? Actually, the story isn't about a ghost at all, is it?
Really? I must have totally missed the point.
Well, I suppose you did only glance over it, after all. But remember, poets often express their own thoughts, feelings, and experiences in their work. They usually do more than tell a simple story or paint a picture. In this case, perhaps the subject of the poem is only being symbolically compared to a ghost, lingering in her last remaining place of comfort, unable to let go of the past, and soon to be left with nothing.
That's a lot more solemn, putting it that way. I hadn't even thought about that. That's impressive.
It's nothing really. Well, it makes me happy that you think that. Just remember, it won't be long before you pick up on these things too.
Yeah, maybe you're right. I guess I'll have to keep trying.
I'm counting on you.
I guess show it to Monica. See what she thinks.
Hi, SN. Having a good time so far?
Yeah.
Good. Glad to hear it. By the way, since you're new and everything, if you ever have a suggestion for the club, like new activities or things we can do better, I'm always listening. Don't be afraid to bring things up, okay?
All right. I'll keep that in mind. Of course, I'll be afraid to bring things up. I'm much better off just going with the flow until I'm more settled in.
Anyway, want to share your poem with me?
It's kind of embarrassing, but I guess I have to.
Don't worry. We're all a little embarrassed today, you know? But it's sort of a barrier that we all have to learn and get past soon.
Yeah, that's true. I hand Monica my poem.
I like this one. Makes me think of something Sayori would like.
Is that so?
You and Sayori are really good friends, right? I wouldn't be surprised if you had the sorts of things in common.
Well... We may be good friends, but Sayori and I are actually really different.
Well, that might be the case, but maybe there's also some similarities that you wouldn't expect. The way she talks about you? Sounds like you two really care about each other's well-being. Even though you show it in different ways, it ends up being more similar than you think. So, I think that's the kind of vibe I get when reading your poem.
Sure you're not reading into this too much?
It could be. Oh gosh, you sound like Yuri. In any case, Sayori's writing is kind of gentle feel to it. I can tell she likes exploring with emotions, like happiness and sadness. Who knew that someone so happy could enjoy sad things too?
Yeah, that's totally unexpected.
Well, to each their own. And you shouldn't be afraid to experiment a little, either.
I'm sure I'll end up trying different things a lot. It could take a while before I feel comfortable doing this.
That's okay. I'd love to see you try new things. That's the best way to find the kind of style that suits you. Everyone might be a little bit biased towards their own kinds of styles, but always help you find what suits you the most. I'll always help you find it. So don't force yourself to write the way everyone else wants you to write. It's not like you have to worry about impressing them or anything.
I mean, at its core, at least at this point, it's still a dating sim, and yes, we're trying to impress them. But...
Anyway, you want to read my poem?
Okay, Monica, what do you got?
Don't worry, I'm not very good.
You sound pretty confident for someone who claims to be not very... who claims to not be very good.
Well, that's because I don't sound good. That's because I have to sound confident. That doesn't mean I always feel that way, you know?
I see. Well, let's read it then. Hole in wall. It couldn't have been me. See, the direction the spackle protrudes. A noisy neighbor? An angry boyfriend? I'll never know. I wasn't home. I peer inside for a clue. No, I can't see. I reel, blind, like a film left out in the sun. But it's too late. My retinas, already scorched with a permanent copy of the meaningless image. It's just a little hole. It wasn't too bright. It was too deep, stretching forever into everything. A hole of infinite choices. I realize now that I wasn't looking in. I was looking out. And he, on the other side, was looking in. That is way more deep than I'm prepared to get.
So, what do you think?
It's very freeform, if that's what you call it. Sorry, I'm not really the right person to ask for feedback.
It's okay. Yeah, that kind of style has gotten pretty popular nowadays. That is, a lot of poems have been putting emphasis on timing between words.
Hey, Rito. Let me bring you up to speed. So, at least so far, we've gone about almost an hour and a half in. This has been presented as a kind of visual novel, high school dating sim kind of thing. We are just a high schooler. We decided on the encouragement of our childhood friend to join a club. The club that we joined with her was the literature club. And on the first night, we were instructed to write a poem. We wrote a poem. The poem that we wrote had various words. Each word kind of ended up tripping interest in from the various characters. There is the friend character. There is the tsundere kind of youngish character. And then there's the kind of brooding, like, shy character. And then there's Monica, who is the president of the club. And so far, we haven't hit the wall yet, but I know at a certain point, the game goes off the rails. And it's just a matter of time. But right now, it's still pleasant and, yeah. Like, the closest thing we've had to it getting off-kilter is some of the poem suggested words were a little weird. But yeah, that's more or less that's kind of where we're at this point in the story. We joined a club. It's the literature club. And yeah, our poem that we wrote more or less leaned us towards the childhood friend.
A lot of poems have put emphasis on timing between words and lines. When performed out loud, it can be really powerful.
What was the inspiration behind this one?
Well, I'm not sure how to put it. I guess you could say I had kind of an epiphany recently. It's been influencing my poems a bit.
An epiphany?
Yeah, something like that. Kind of a little nervous to talk about deep stuff like that, because it's kind of coming on strongly. After everyone is getting is better friends with each other. Anyway, here's Monica's writing tip of the day. Sometimes when you're writing a poem or story, your brain gets too fixated on a specific point. If you try hard to make it perfect, then you'll never make any progress. Just force yourself to get something down on paper and tidy it up later. Another way to think about it is this. If you keep your pen in the same spot for too long, you'll just make a big, dark puddle of ink. So, move your hand. Go with the flow. That's my advice. Thanks for listening.
Okay. Phew. I guess that's everyone. I glance around the room. That was a little more stressful than I anticipated. It's as if everyone is judging me for my mediocre writing abilities. Even if they're just being nice, there's no way my poems can stand up to theirs. Rito, do you have any familiarity with this? Do you know where this is going? I know through just general video game, like, knowledge in the sphere of, you know, I know where this goes, but I don't know how much other people know. This is a literature club, after all. I sigh. I guess that's what I ended up getting myself into. Across the room, Sayori and Monika are happily chatting. Enjoy it as best you can, because, yeah, eventually it does go off the rails. Right now, we're just in the nice, pleasant, lulling people into a false sense of security stage. My eyes land on Yuri and Natsuki. They gingerly exchange sheets of paper, sharing their respective poems. As they read in tandem, I watch each of their expressions change. Natsuki's eyebrows furrow in frustration. Meanwhile, Yuri smiles sadly.
What's with this language? Did you say something? Oh, it's nothing.
Natsuki dismissively returns the poem to the desk with one hand.
I guess you could say it's fancy. Thanks. Yours is cute. Cute? Did you completely miss the symbolism or something? It's clearly about the feeling of giving up. How could that be cute? I know that. I just meant the language, I guess. I was trying to say something nice. You mean you have to try that hard to come up with something nice to say? Thanks, but it really didn't come out nice at all. Well, I do have a couple of suggestions. If I was looking for suggestions, I would have asked someone who actually liked it. Which people did, by the way. Sayori liked it. And SN did too. So based on that, I'll gladly give you some suggestions of my own. First of all, excuse me. I appreciate the offer, but I've spent a long time establishing my writing style. I don't expect it to change anytime soon. Unless, of course, I come across something particularly inspiring. Which I haven't yet. And SN liked my poem too, you know. He even told me he was impressed by it.
Natsuki suddenly stands up.
Oh? I didn't realize you were so invested in trying to impress our new member, Yuri. Eh? That's not what I... You're just...
Yuri stands up as well.
Maybe you're just jealous that SN appreciates my advice more than he appreciates yours. Huh? And how do you know he didn't appreciate my advice more? Are you that full of yourself? I... No. If I was full of myself, I would deliberately go out of my way to make everything I do
overly cutesy? Oh, jeez. She's coming at her. She's throwing it down. She's, like, throwing down the gauntlet here.
Is everyone okay?
No, they're not okay. They're, like, arguing, and it's not good.
Well, you know what?
I wasn't the one with whose boobs magically grew bigger as soon as SN started showing up.
Atsuki, that's a little... This doesn't involve you. I don't like fighting guys. Suddenly, both
girls turned towards me, as if they just noticed I was standing there.
SN, she's trying to make me look bad. It's not true. She started it. If she could get over herself and learn to appreciate simple writing is more effective, then this wouldn't have happened in the first place. What's the point of making your poems all convoluted for no reason? The meaning should jump out at the reader, not force them to have to figure it out. Help me explain that to her, SN. Wait. There's a reason we have so many deep and expressive words in our language. The only way to convey complex feelings and meaning the most effectively. Avoiding them is not only unnecessarily limiting yourself, it's also a waste. You understand that, right, SN?
How did I get dragged into this in the first place? It's not like I know anything about writing. But whoever I agree with, they'll probably think more highly of me. So, what's it gonna be? Help me, Sayori. Natsuki? Natsuki glares at me, drawing up any words I had in my mouth. So instead, I turn to Yuri. Yuri? But Yuri's expression is so defenseless that I can't bring myself to say anything to her. Sayori?
Eh?
Yeah. Everyone's fighting is making Sayori uncomfortable. How can you two keep fighting when you know you're making your friend feel like this?
SN? Well, that's her problem. This isn't about her. I agree. It's unfair for others to interject their own feelings into our conflict. Yeah, unless Sayori wants to tell Yuri what a stuck-up jerk she's being. She would never. It's your immaturity that made her upset in the first place. Excuse me? Are you listening to yourself? This is exactly why nobody likes you.
Stop.
Natsuki, Yuri, you guys are my friends. I just want everyone to get along and be happy. My friends are wonderful people, and I love them because of their differences. Natsuki's poems, they're amazing because they give you so many feelings with just a few words. And Yuri's poems are amazing because they paint beautiful pictures in your head. Everyone's so talented. So, why are we fighting? Also, Natsuki's cute, and there's nothing wrong with that. And Yuri's boobs are the same as they've always been. What? Big and beautiful.
Sayori? Sayori stands triumphantly. Monika stands behind her with a bewildered expression.
I'll make some tea.
Whoa, she just rushed off the thing fast. Natsuki sits down with a blank expression on her face, staring at nothing. So, this is why Sayori is vice president. I whispered to Monika. She nods in return.
To be honest, I might come off as a good leader, and I can organize things, but I'm not very good with people. I couldn't even bring myself to interject. As president, that's kind of embarrassing of me.
Nah. It's not like I can blame you. I wasn't able to say anything either.
Well, I guess that just means Sayori is amazing in her own ways, isn't she?
You could say that. She might be an airhead, but sometimes it's weirdly suspicious that she knows exactly what she's doing.
I see. Take good care of her, okay?
I would hate to see her get herself hurt. That makes two of us. You can count on me. Monica smiles sweetly at me, causing my stomach to knot. Such a genuine person really does make a good president, regardless of what she says. If only I could get a chance to talk to her a little more.
Okay, everyone. It's just about time for us to leave. Now, how do y'all feel about sharing poems? It's a lot of fun. Well, I'd say it was worth it. It's all right. Well, mostly. SN, what about you?
Yeah. I'd say the same. It was a neat thing to talk about with everyone.
Awesome. In that case, we'll do the same thing tomorrow.
Oh god, not another poem!
And maybe you'll learn something from your friends, too. So your poems will turn out even better.
I think to myself, I did learn a little more about the kinds of poems everyone likes. With any luck, that means I can at least do a better job impressing those I want to impress. I nod to myself with newfound determination.
Listen, ready to walk home?
Sure, let's go. Sayori beams at me. It truly has been a while since Sayori and I have spent this much time together. I can't really say I'm not enjoying it either. Sayori, about what happened earlier?
What do you mean?
You know, between Yuri and Natsuki. Does that kind of thing happen often?
No. It's really the first time I've seen them fight like that. I promise, they're both wonderful people. You don't hate them, do you?
No, I don't hate them. I just wanted your opinion, that's all. I can see why they'd make good friends with you.
Phew. You know, Asen, it's nice get to spend time with you at the club. But I think seeing you get along with everyone is what makes me the happiest. And I think everyone really likes you too.
That's...
Every day is gonna be so much fun.
Sigh. Looks like Sayori still hasn't caught on to the kind of situation I'm in. Sure, being friends with everyone is nice, but... does it really need to stop there? Well, we'll just have to see where the future holds, or what the future holds, Sayori. I pat Sayori on the shoulder. I said that more to myself than to her, but it's easy to use Sayori as an internal monologue sometimes.
Okay.
Yeah. Let's do this. Oh god, we're gonna write another poem. Okay. We got another poem. Like, cutesy stuff is the stuff that Natsuki likes. Like sad and creepy stuff is... Like, I'm not sure which one would get imagination other than maybe Sayori? Yuri, yeah, Yuri's gonna be the sad stuff, like disaster or misery or maybe Fester. So it's like, do we still just kind of go for Sayori, I guess? Oh, I didn't expect imagination to be heard. Like Bouncy is Natsuki, I think. trying to find which one's meant to go with who. Wait, Tragedy was her? Why was Tragedy her? Like, we're getting more Natsuki again. Pout. Yeah, we're just getting a whole bunch of Natsuki here. I don't know how that's going to affect things since we were with Sayori in the first one. Strawberry. Yeah, we're just... I'm not actively trying exactly to get Natsuki, but we're just... I think she's been like 8 of the first 10. Unrequited? Sheesh. We're getting a few more of Sayori. Like, Kawaii, that's probably Sayori? Yeah, we're somewhere in between Sayori and Natsuki. We have not had hardly any for her, for Yuri. Yeah, I feel like we might just barely be Sayori again, but I can't quite tell. Somewhere between, it's either Sayori or Natsuki, and I have no idea which one we leaned a little more towards. Another day passes, and it's time for another club meeting. I've gotten a little more comfortable over the past couple days. Entering the club room, the usual scene greets me. Hi, Asen. Yo, Sayori. Looks like you're in a good mood today. I'm just still not used to being in, used to you being in the club, that's all. I see. It's a pretty simple thing to get you in the good mood. But I guess it's always the simple things with you, anyway. Speaking of which, I'm kind of hungry. Will you come with me to buy a snack? No thanks. Hey? That's not like you at all. I have my reasons. Why don't we take a look at your purse, Sayori? Huh? Eh? Why that all of a sudden? No reason, really. I just wanted to look at it.
What is...
Sayori nervously retrieves her coin purse. She fumbles with the latch and gets it open. And then she turns it upside down and lets the contents spill onto the desk. Only 2 small coins fall out. I knew it. I can see right through you, Sayori.
That's not fair! How did you even know?
It's simple. If you had enough money in the first place, you would have bought a snack before coming to the club room. So, either you're not hungry and want an excuse to take a walk, or you plan to conveniently forget that you spent all your money so that I would lend you some. But there's one more thing. You're always hungry. And so that only leaves the one option.
Wah! I give up.
Don't make me feel guilty. If you feel guilty, that's because you deserve to feel guilty. Yuri suddenly giggles. Eh? I didn't notice that she was listening in. Her face is in her book, as always.
I wasn't listening or anything. It was just something in my book. Yuri, tell Ascend to let me borrow some money. Don't get me involved like that, Sayori. Besides, you should only buy what you can responsibly afford. And frankly, after pulling a mischievous little stunt like that, your suffering is fair enough retribution. Sheesh! Whew. Did I just... I didn't mean that. I got too absorbed in my book. I really like when you speak your mind, Yuri. Doesn't happen much, but it's a fun side to you. There's no way you could think that. You're right, though. I did something bad, and now I have to accept the revolution.
Accept the revolution?
Retribution.
Oh.
That. Still, coming from you, Sayori, I guess there's little devil inside of us all. Inside of all of us, isn't there?
Don't let her fool you. Sayori knows exactly what she's doing. After all, she told you guys that she is bringing me in the club before she even told me.
But you wouldn't have come if it weren't for the cupcakes. So I had to trick Natsuki into making them.
Come on. Give me more credit than that, Sayori. Out of nowhere, something smacks Sayori in the face and tumbles onto the desk. Whap!
Yeah! Ow! That was the... a cookie!
A cookie? Sure enough, it's a giant cookie wrapped in plastic. Sayori glances around.
Is this a miracle?
No, it's a cookie!
Cause I paid my restitution!
Retribution.
Actually, that one almost worked. I was just gonna give it to you. But then I heard you blab about the cupcakes. It was totally worth seeing your reaction, though. Natsuki! It's nice of you. I'm so happy.
Sayori hugs the cookie.
Hugs the cookie?
Jeez, just eat it. Sayori rapidly tears open the wrapper and takes a big bite.
So good.
Sayori suddenly clasps her hands over her mouth.
A bit my tongue. You're going through a lot. Over just one cookie.
Natsuki takes a bite of her own cookie.
Yours looks really good too, Natsuki. Can I try it? Jeez. Beggars can't be choosers. But yours is chocolate. Yeah. Why do you think I gave you that one? Fine. Still, I'm really happy you shared this one with me.
Sayori gets out of her seat, goes behind Natsuki, and then wraps her arms around her.
Oh, jeez! I get it. Cookie's still
in hand. Natsuki reaches up to nudge Sayori off her. Sayori suddenly leans down and takes a bite of Natsuki's cookie!
Hey! Did you seriously just do that? Uh-huh.
Mouthful, Sayori trots away to safety. Yuri and I laugh as well.
Jeez, such a kid sometimes. Monika, Can you tell Sayori?
Natsuki glances around. Monika isn't in the club room.
Where's Monika anyway? Good question. Have you heard anything about her being late today? Not me.
Yeah, I haven't either.
It's a bit unusual. Hope she's okay. Of course she's okay. She's probably just had something to do. She's pretty popular after all. You don't think she has a... I wouldn't be surprised. She's probably more desirable than all of us combined. That's true. Excuse me?
Suddenly the door swings open.
Sorry, super sorry.
There you are.
I didn't mean to be late. I hope you guys weren't worried or anything. Monika chose the club over her boyfriend after all. You're so strong-willed. Boyfriend? What on earth are you talking about?
Monika quizzically glances at me. Never mind that. What held you up anyway?
Well, my last period today was study hall. To be honest, I kinda lost track of time. That makes no sense, though. You would have heard the bell ring, at least. I must have heard it since I was... I must not have heard it since I was practicing piano. Piano? I wasn't aware you played music as well, Monika. I don't, really. I just kind of started recently. I just wanted to learn the piano. That's so cool! You should play something. That's...
Monika looks at me.
Maybe once I get a little better, I will. Yay!
That sounds cool. I'd also look forward to that.
That's so. In that case, I won't let you down, Sen. Monika smiles sweetly.
I didn't mean any pressure or anything like that.
Don't worry. I've been practicing a whole lot recently. And I'd love a chance to share once I'm ready.
I see. In that case, best of luck.
Thanks. So, did I miss anything?
Not really. I choose to leave out Sayori's mischievous escapade. I'm sure Natsuki will end up complaining to her anyway. It looks like everyone has already settled down. Sayori somehow already finished her entire cookie. Yuri is back to her book, and Natsuki disappeared into the closet.
Ascent!
Sayori suddenly comes up to me.
I'm gonna have to get some supplies from another classroom. Wanna come with me?
Supplies? What for?
Well, you know, how the festival is coming up. Me and Monika are gonna make some posters and stuff. So, we need to go get some crayons and markers and glue sticks.
Ah, I see. Sure, I'll go with you.
Yay! Okay, Monika, we'll be back soon. Are you going with SN to get the supplies? There's no need to trouble yourself. I'll be happy to go with him. I wanted to go. So much fun exploring empty classrooms and stuff. Okay. It's just a suggestion. See if you can find poster paper, too. Okay. Ready?
Yep. Let's go. Sayori and I exit the club room. I follow behind as Sayori hums and skips around the hallway. Honestly, it feels like I'm taking a kid to the mall or something. Sayori finds pleasure in the simplest little things, sometimes.
Hey, Sayori. What exactly are we doing for the festival anyway? I'm not sure how you would make an event out of literature.
Me and Monica have it all planned out. Don't you worry.
Is that so?
Yep. We're gonna do a poetry performance.
A performance? Of what kind?
Well, everyone's gonna take turns on stage and recite their favorite poems.
Ah, that sounds kinda dull.
Miss N, not thinking about from the right way at all. It's not just about reading poems, it's about performing them. Like, you say the lines of the poem like, between my feet, the last remaining flower beckons to me. I twist the stem, freeing it from its clinging roots. Caressing the final joyous moment between my fingers. But to what ends have I summoned this joy? For now, when I look in every direction, the once prosperous field before me is but a barren wasteland. Like that.
Sayori, how do I put this? I'm sure it's just me, but it's impossible for me to take you seriously when you talk like that.
Hey?
Still though, it's like, does this thing, that's just...
You meanie! I'm working super hard on this, you know?
I know. I just meant that it's pretty unordinary. It's pretty unordinary contrast to your cute self.
Don't say that, it's embarrassing. But I guess that means I'm doing a good job.
Yeah, I guess so.
I'm so excited. The festival is going to be so much fun.
Sayori spins herself around in the hallway again.
Hey, listen, this classroom over here is empty. Let's begin the mission.
The mission, eh? It's been a long time since I've spent time with Sayori like this. But in the end, she hasn't changed one bit. She's nothing but a ball of sunshine, drawing happy vibes from the world around her. It's a pretty nostalgic feeling for me. As the years went by, I began to hole myself up in my room more and more. So going adventuring with Sayori brings about a special sort of feeling I forgot I had in me. Two of us enter the classroom. Sayori heads straight to the closet, and I follow.
Let's see what we have in here. Crayons!
Sayori pulls a box full of crayons off the shelf.
They're the best brand, too. They're kind of dirty, though.
Sayori starts pulling various crayons out of the box, reading the color names. Alright, that's one down. Don't get distracted. We still need to find...
Wait, I'm looking for my favorite color.
Fine. Then, at least move aside so I can look for the poster paper.
I dropped one by accident.
Smack.
Yeah.
Sayori bends over and smacks her forehead. Ah! Right on the shelf. She falls to the floor and the crayons spill all over her lap.
Ow.
You okay?
My forehead.
Sayori clutches her forehead. Jeez, Sayori. Just like you, isn't it? Come on, let's see. Since Sayori is sitting on the floor, I grab her by the waist and pull her out of the closet. You have to move your hands, Sayori.
But it hurts.
Just do it for a second. Sayori slowly releases her hand from her forehead. I gently brush her bangs to the side.
Ow!
Sorry. There's a huge red mark in the center of her forehead. A bump is starting to form as well. And that's gonna swell up. I should find you some ice.
Then,
where would I even find ice around this time? I guess a cold drink would do.
You don't have to. I'm fine looking like a unicorn.
Even wincing from the pain, Sayori makes a silly joke. What are you saying? I'll be right back, okay?
Okay.
I pat Sayori on the shoulder and run out into the hallway. I locate the nearest vending machine. What should I get? It doesn't really matter, since it'll be used as an ice pack rather than a drink. But I know Sayori likes apple juice, so I purchased that one. In just a moment, I'm already returning to the classroom where I left Sayori. She has one palm on her forehead and is using the other to clumsily scoop the crayons back into the box.
At least they were already in the wrong spots before I spilled them.
Sayori, here. I hand Sayori the bottle of apple juice.
It's nice and cold.
Sayori opens the cap, starts drinking from it. Sayori, what are you doing? It's for your forehead, idiot.
Sorry, I forgot.
How hard did you hit your head? Sayori places the bottle against the bump on her head.
It stings.
Just bear with it. It'll feel better soon. It looks like you cleaned up most of the crayons, so that's good.
Hey, Asen, this kind of reminds you of growing up, doesn't it?
What do you mean?
You know, how we used to play outside all the time. I would always try to keep up with you. You were kind of oblivious in some ways. Like, I usually fell behind or had trouble climbing on things you did. Sometimes, when I tried to do things I couldn't, I would get myself hurt. I'd fall, scrape myself, get a bump. And then I would start crying really hard. And you would rush over as quick as you could. You would try really hard to get me to stop crying. It's almost like you blamed yourself and were afraid of getting in trouble if someone found out. Even though it wasn't your fault at all, you know?
Did I really do that?
Yeah, you don't remember?
Come to think of it, maybe I do remember a bit. I guess I was always so focused on my games that I didn't pay enough attention to you. So in a way, it was my fault. Kinda like this time too. If I wasn't rushing you out of the closet, you probably wouldn't have hit your head.
Listen, I don't think you realize that you're always thinking about other people. Even after all these years, you're rushing to help me even though I'm just being clumsy. You're really a sweetheart.
Don't call me that. I don't really do this kind of thing all the time. I guess when it comes to you, it just feels natural. Before I even know it, I'm treating you like that. I guess that's what happens when you've been friends for so long.
Really? Maybe you're right. Listen, I'm so glad nothing's changed between us. Do you think it'll be like this forever?
Forever? If I'm honest to myself, there's no telling where we'll end up for college or after that. So it wouldn't be fair for me to make any promises. But, well, I hope so. It's been this long already, right? I can't imagine you ever changing, so my hopes are up.
I'm so happy.
Sayori is whimsical, has a whimsical expression in her eyes. We remain silent for a moment. She's so silly and clumsy on the outside that when I see her deep in thought like this, it makes me not want to disturb her.
I guess we should go back. I don't want to worry Monica, you know.
Good luck with that. She's gonna see your forehead either way.
Not if I hide it under my bangs.
Sayori hops to her feet. She clutches her forehead again. Don't stand up so fast after hurting yourself. Well, I guess it's too late now. Anyway, let's go. I follow Sayori out of the classroom. Sayori plays with her bangs to try to hide the bump, but without much success. In a moment, we make it back to the club room.
You're back. Good timing. We're just ready to start sharing our poems. Sayori, your forehead.
She's fine. Don't worry about it.
I was playing with the crayons and smacked my forehead onto the shelf.
Thought we were gonna, like, try to keep it, like, low-key, not say anything.
Well, anyway, were you able to find everything we needed? Have it right.
Sayori frantically glances around herself.
I forgot this stuff!
Calm down, Sayori. I have it all right here. I found the poster paper, too.
Sounds like you ended up doing all the work, Issa.
Well, Sayori... I failed to come up with an excuse for Sayori.
I made it an adventure!
Yeah, that.
No, okay. In any case, good work. I'll start working on the posters tonight. Me too. Okay, everyone. Are you ready to share your poems?
I guess I should grab mine. After making sure the crayon box is closed tightly, I return to my seat. Should I share the poem with first? I mean, it was either Sayori and Natsuki that were tagged their little chibi whatever jumped the most, right? Might as well just start with Sayori, right?
Asen, I really love your poems. I can't believe you've been hiding these from me.
Like hell if I know poems. I'm not hiding anything.
But your poems are so good. Yesterday's and this one too? You can't tell me you haven't done this before.
I mean, you're really the only one who feels that way, so...
No way. Not even Natsuki?
Well, I guess Natsuki is at least likely to admit that she... I guess Natsuki is the least likely to admit she likes something. But I don't think it's that.
What do you mean?
Well, I guess I'll be honest about it. It's a lot easier to write poems when I'm thinking about you.
Eh?
Stop thinking weird things, idiot. I just mean that you're really expressive person. And I guess... So, how am I supposed to write poems about my own student life? But you somehow make everything in your life an adventure. Even the little things.
Like cooking?
Let's not talk about that. So yeah. I guess what I'm saying is I can feel more feelings through you than I can through myself. We have that kind of weird connection. It's your fault for getting in my business all the time.
Eh?
I don't know if I understand.
You never understand when I try to explain things to you, do you, Sayori? I pat Sayori's head.
I'm not a kid, you know.
Are you sure about that?
Maybe.
Sayori starts fiddling with her pencil between her hands.
Hey, Asen, will you give me your poem? I kind of want to keep it.
Huh? Why?
Because, well, it's the first time you've written something for me.
Sayori, you completely misunderstood. I didn't write this for you. Are you even listening anymore? Well, whatever. I'll give it to you when we get home.
Really?
Snap.
I broke my pencil.
Sayori hastily bends down to pick up the piece she dropped. But being inattentive of her surroundings, she bumps right into me.
Sorry.
It's fine. I'll get it for you. I bend down, pick up the broken pencil. Sayori clutches the desk beside her to support herself, knees shaking.
I'm a little clumsy today.
Well, let's sit down, Sayori.
Yeah.
I grab Sayori's arm and help her sit at the desk. Anyway, I still haven't read your poem.
Oh, sorry about that. It's not as good as yours.
Jeez, don't worry. I'm sure I'll like it. Bottles. I pop off my scalp like the lid of a cookie jar. It's the secret place where I keep all my dreams. Little balls of sunshine, all rubbing together like a bundle of kittens. I reach inside with my thumb and forefinger and pluck one out. It's warm and tingly, but there's no time to waste. I put it in the bottle to keep it safe. And I put the bottle on the shelf with all the other bottles. Happy thoughts in bottles, all in a row. My collection makes me lots of friends, each bottle of starlight to make amends. Sometimes my friend feels a certain way, down comes a bottle to save the day. Night after night, more dreams, friend after friend, more bottles. Deeper and deeper my fingers go, like exploring a dark cave, discovering the secrets hiding in the nooks and crannies. Digging and digging, scraping and scraping. I blow dust off my bottle caps. It doesn't feel like time elapsed. My empty shelf could use some more. My friends look through my locked front door. Finally, all done. I open up, and in come my friends. In they come in such a hurry. Do they want my bottles that much? I frantically pull them from the shelf, one after the other, holding them out to each and every friend, each and every bottle. But every time I let one go, it shatters against the tile between my feet. Happy thoughts in shards all over the floor. They were supposed to be for my friends who aren't smiling. They're all shouting, pleading, something. But all I hear is echo, 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 echo inside my head. That got a little odd. But okay, let's see where this goes. Holy crap! Sayori, did you really write this?
Of course I did. Didn't I tell you yesterday I was gonna write the best poem ever?
Yeah, but I mean, I didn't expect something like this coming from you.
Monica taught me a whole lot. I've been really in touch with my feelings recently.
I see that. It
It's almost kind of creepy.
Creepy?
Well, not exactly. Maybe because I'm not used to you being cheerful. Well, never mind. I'm thinking too hard about it. The point is, it came out good. You should be proud of it.
Oh, thanks. I feel like it was meant to express myself this way. It helps me understand my feelings a little bit better. Writing is like magic.
You've gotten pretty passionate about this, huh? I hope you keep it up.
Yeah. Writing's the best. I'm gonna keep writing until I die.
Don't get ahead of yourself. Sayori's always got a habit of getting obsessed with something before dropping it no more than a week later. I wonder if this is one of those times. But seeing the passion in her eyes makes it hard for me to be pessimistic. Let's just go down the line. Honestly, I don't know.
Well, it's not really any worse than your last one. I can't say it's any better either.
Phew.
Phew what?
Well, anything that isn't a train wreck, I'll take as a win. And I get the feeling you're probably the most critical.
Hey, what makes you... Wait, maybe that was a compliment? Glad to see someone recognizes my experience. Well then, keep practicing and maybe you'll be as good as me someday.
That's, something tells me Natsuki completely missed the point.
Come to think of it, this kind of reminds me of Sayori's poem from yesterday.
You think so?
Yeah, well, I guess if you've been friends for so long, you might be on the same wavelength. But you never really struck me as her type.
Sayori has a type all of a sudden?
Well, I don't know. But honestly, how can someone so fluffy spend so much time with someone like you? It's like she's dragging around dead weight.
That was a little unnecessary. But think of it this way. If it weren't for me, she would probably just fly away, like letting go of a balloon. You could say we take care of each other in our own way.
Whatever it is, I don't get it. Oh yeah, I guess I'm supposed to show you my poem. Here.
Amy likes spiders. You know what I heard about Amy? Amy likes spiders. Icky, wriggly, hairy, ugly spiders. That's why I'm not friends with her. Amy has a cute singing voice. I heard her singing my favorite love song. Every time she sang the chorus, my heart would pound to the rhythm of the words. But she likes spiders. That's why I'm not friends with her. One time, I hurt my leg really bad. Amy helped me up and took me to the nurse. I tried not to let her touch me. She likes spiders, so her hands are probably gross. That's why I'm not friends with her. Amy has a lot of friends. I always see her talking to people. She probably talks about spiders. What if her friends start to like spiders too? That's why I'm not friends with her. It doesn't matter if she has other hobbies. It doesn't matter if she keeps it private. It doesn't matter if it doesn't hurt anyone. It's gross. She's gross. The world is better off without spider lovers. And I'm gonna tell everyone.
Sure. Not bad, right?
It's quite a bit longer than yesterday's.
Yesterday's was too short. I was just warming up. I hope you didn't think that was the best I could do.
No, of course not.
Anyway, the message is pretty straightforward in this poem. I doubt I have to explain it. Sometimes you can explain complicated issues with some simpler analogies. And it helps people realize how stupid they're being. Like, anyone would agree with the subject of this poem is an ignorant jerk.
Do you know people like that?
Of course, it's how everyone thinks my... it doesn't matter, it can be about anything. I wrote it to be easy to relate to. Everyone has some kind of weird hobby or guilty pleasure. Something that you're afraid people find out, make fun of you or think less of you. But that just makes people stupid. Who cares what someone likes? As long as they're not hurting anyone, it makes them happy. I think people really need to learn to respect others for weird things. For liking weird things.
Well, you're definitely right. At least, I can relate to that. At least, I'm sure a lot of other people can, too.
That's what I do best, after all. I don't like writing unless there's a good message to take away from it. Like, conveying emotions is important. But I want to make people think, not just feel. Remember that. I'm going to write a good one for tomorrow, so look forward to it.
I think when we finish this day, I'm going to save, and even if the bottom doesn't drop out, I'm going to come back to this next week, and we'll keep going next week, but we'll finish this day of whatever is happening, and then next week is probably when it'll all go crazy, but you know what? Let's find out what Yuri wrote.
What crazy nonsense did Yuri write this time?
Let's see what you've written for today. Well done, Isen. Your skills are already improving.
Really? Thanks, Yuri. Coming from you, that means a lot.
Huh? It's nothing. I'm just happy to help inspire fellow writers. I know you're new to this, so don't worry so much if it seems like you can't get your poem to feel perfect. You don't need to be afraid to be a little more daring. Metaphors can go a long way. Don't feel like you need to work your brain like turning a bunch of gears. Try letting your mind wander through your feelings. And write down the things you hear and you see and hear. It's one way to truly enable the reader you see into your mind. It's a very intimate exercise.
I see. That's certainly an interesting technique.
Thanks for sharing.
Stretch, I can stretch. And I can drink as well, yes. I've been having to drink some amount because so much talking today.
I have an example, if you'd like to read it.
Of course. Is this the poem you wrote for today? Yuri nods and timidly hands me her poem. The Raccoon. It happened in the dead of the night. It happened in the dead of night while I was slicing bread for a guilty snack. My attention was caught by the scuttering of a raccoon outside my window. That was, I believe, the first time I noticed my strange tendencies as an unordinary human. I gave the raccoon a piece of bread, my subconscious well aware of the consequences. Well aware that the raccoon that is fed will always come back for more. The enticing beauty of my cutting knife was the symptom. The bread, my hungry curiosity. The raccoon, an urge. The moon increments its phase and reflects that much more light off my cutting knife. The very same light that glistens in the eyes of the raccoon, of my raccoon friend, I slice the bread, fresh and soft. The raccoon becomes excited. Or perhaps I'm merely projecting my emotions onto the newly satisfied animal. The raccoon has taken to following me. I could say that we've gotten quite used to each other. The raccoon becomes hungry more and more frequently, so my bread is always handy. Every time I brandish my cutting knife, the raccoon shows me its excitement. A rush of blood, classic Pavlovian conditioning. I slice the bread, and I feel myself again. And I feed myself again.
I was a little more daring with this one than yesterday's.
I could see that. It's a lot more metaphorical. I don't know if it's my fault, but I can't begin to imagine what this poem is about.
That's right. It's a bit closer to my preferred writing style. Using the poem as a canvas to express vivid imagery and convey emotions through them.
Yeah, if I take it at face value, then I can't even figure out what it's supposed to mean.
Well, I think it's something that different people can relate to in their own way. I wanted to express my feelings for... I want to express the way it feels for me to indulge in my more unusual hobbies. It's those sorts of things that usually force to keep to myself. So, I sometimes enjoy writing about them.
Huh, that's funny.
Did Natsuki also write something about that?
About someone being ridiculed for strange interests?
Huh. She did?
Yeah. She was talking about how it doesn't matter what you're into, as long as you aren't hurting anybody.
She's right. I mean, does she really feel that way?
Yeah. Sounds like you two have that in common.
Well, that's interesting. To me, she seemed like the kind of person who would make fun of my hobbies. But I suppose that's my fault for judging, isn't it? Please, don't tell her I said that.
Don't worry. I have no reason to.
Okay. Well, thank you for sharing it with me. After all, I hadn't learned to embrace my own weirdness. I would probably hate myself. I might be ranting a little bit now. But I'm glad you're a good listener.
Guess Monica?
Hi, Asen. How's the writing going?
Alright, I guess.
I'll take that. As long as it's not going bad. I'm happy that you're applying yourself. Maybe you'll come up with a masterpiece.
I wouldn't count on that.
You never know. Want to share what you wrote today?
Sure. Here you go. I give my poem to Monica.
All right. Pretty good. Makes me think of Sayori, like the other one you wrote. You two are like a dynamic duo.
That's kind of exaggerating it.
Yeah, probably. You do spend a lot of time with her, even in this club, don't you? Then again, I don't blame you for being a little shy.
I'm not shy, it's just...
I'm just teasing. I know it takes time to make friends with everyone.
Yuri and Natsuki are super interesting people, so don't be afraid to give them their share of time. And you can talk to me every now and then, too. I'm not, like, unapproachable or anything, am I?
No, it's nothing like that. I'm just still getting used to being here, that's all.
Yeah. I'm sorry if I put pressure on you or something. I really didn't mean it like that.
No, don't worry. I get what you're saying.
Well, alright. But anyway, you wanna read my poem now? I like the way this one turned out. I hope you do too.
Alright, let's take a look. Save me. The colors, they won't stop. Bright, beautiful colors. Flashing, expanding, piercing. Red, green, blue. An endless cacophony of meaningless noise. The noise, it won't stop. Violet, grating waveforms. Squeaking, screeching, piercing. Sine, cosine, tangent, like playing a chalkboard on a turntable, like playing a vinyl on a pizza crust, an endless poem of meaningless. Load me. That's
weird. That's a bit of weird.
Huh. It's even more abstract than your last one, huh?
I guess that's just the way I write. I'm sorry you don't like it.
No, I never said that. It's just kind of a thing I've never really seen before, I guess.
I like to play with my space on the paper. Choosing where to space your words can totally change the mood of the poem. It's almost like magic. The way I wrote the lines, really short, makes it feel like trying to speak over the noise.
I see. Still hard for me to tell what it's about, though.
Sometimes asking what a poem is about isn't the right question. A poem can be abstract as a physical expression of a feeling, or a conversation with the reader. So putting it that way, not every poem is about something. Anyway, here's Monica's writing tip of the day. Sometimes you find yourself facing a difficult decision. What happens, don't forget to save your game.
When that happens, don't forget to save your game. You never know when you might change your mind. Okay. I saved my game. Are you happy now? Okay, we saved the game. I hope Monica's happy with us now.
Or when something unexpected may happen. Wait, is this tip even about writing? What am I even talking about? That's my advice for today. Thanks for listening.
That was weird.
Okay, everyone. We're all done reading each other's poems, right? I have something extra planned, so if everyone can come sit in the front of the room. Is this about the festival? Well, sort of. Do we really have to do something for the festival? It's not like we can put together anything good in just a few days. Well, we'll just end up embarrassing ourselves instead of getting any new members. That's a concern of mine as well. I don't really do well with last-minute preparations. Don't worry so much. We're going to keep it simple. We don't need much more than a few decorations. Sayori's been working on posters. I've designed some pamphlets we can give out during the event. Okay, that's great and all. But that doesn't tell us what we're actually going to be doing for the event. Oh,
Sorry, I thought you heard about it already. We're gonna be performing. Performing. But... Monica... Yeah, we're gonna be having a poetry performance. Each of us is going to choose a poem to recite during the event. The cool part is, we're gonna let anyone else come up and recite poems too. Sayori, putting it all on the posters in case anyone wants to prepare ahead of time.
Sayori, who's been coloring a poster, holds it up for us to see.
Are you kidding me, Monica? You didn't already start putting those posters up, did you? Well, I did. Do you really think it's that bad of an idea? Well, no. It's not that bad of an idea. It's just... But I didn't sign up for this, you know? There's no way I'm gonna be performing in front of a group of people like that. I agree with Natsuki. I could never in my life do something like that.
Imagining it, Yuri shakes her head in fear.
Guys... No, Sayori. I understand where you're coming from. Remember that Natsuki and Yuri have never shared their poems with anyone until just a couple days ago. It's a lot easier for them to recite the poems out loud to a whole room full of people. I guess I kind of overlooked that. So, I'm sorry. But... I still think we should give it our best. We're the only ones responsible for the fate of this club. If we start the event and each put on a good performance, then we'll inspire others to do the same. And more people who perform, the better we'll be able to show everyone what literature is all about. Yeah! It's about expressing your feelings. Being intimate with yourself, finding new horizons, and having fun. That's right. And it's those reasons that we're all in this club today. Don't you want to share that with others? To inspire them to find the same feeling that brought you here in the first place. I know you do. I know we all do. And if all it takes is standing in front of a room for 2 minutes and reciting a poem, then I know you can do it.
Natsuki and Yuri remain silent. Sayori looks worried. I guess that leaves me with no choice. I agree. I don't think it's too much to ask. I think Sayori and Monica have been really hard, and have been trying really hard to get new members. The least we can do is help them out a little bit.
Well, maybe, but...
Looks like Natsuki doesn't have any arguments left.
Okay, fine. I guess I'll just have to get it over with. Alright. Phew. Thanks, Natsuki. What about you, Yuri?
Yuri dejectedly glances around at everyone else's expectant faces.
Guess I don't really have a choice. That's everyone. You're the best, Yuri. This club is seriously going to be the death of me. Gosh. You'll be fine, Yuri. But anyway, let's move on to the main event. I want each of you to choose a poem of yours. I'm going to practice reciting them in front of people. Or in front of each other. No way! Monica! This is too sudden. Well, and can't recite your poem in front of a club, how do you expect to do it in front of strangers? Oh no. Don't worry. I'll start off helping everyone feel a little more comfortable. Can I go? Next? Of course. Now, let's see.
Monica flips through her notebook to a specific poem she has in mind for herself. She then stands behind the podium. The title of this poem
is The Way They Fly.
Monica begins reciting her poem. Her clear, confident voice fills the room. More than that, her inflection is pristine. She knows exactly how to apply emotion behind each line she recites, bringing the words to life. Is this something she's done before? Or is she simply a natural? I glance around me. Everyone has their eyes on Monica. Sayori looks amazed. Yuri has an intense expression on her face, but I don't understand. Or has an intense expression on her face that I don't understand. Finally, Monica finishes the recitation. The four of us applaud. Monica takes a breath and smiles.
That was so good, Monica. Thank you very much. I was just hoping to set a good example. Are you ready to go next, Sayori? I'll go next. Well, Yuri's fired up all of a sudden.
Yuri clutches a sheet of paper between her hands and stands up. Keeping her head down, she walks quickly over to the podium.
This poem is called...
Yuri anxiously glances at each of us.
You can do it, Yuri. It's called After Image of a Crimson Eye.
Yuri's voice shakes as she starts reading the poem. Just a moment ago, she practically refused to do this. Why is she suddenly putting in so much effort? As Yuri gets past the first couple of lines, her voice changes. It's almost like what happens when Yuri gets absorbed into her books. Her quivering words transforms into the sharp syllables of a fierce and confident woman. The poem is full of twists and turns in its structure that she enunciates with perfect timing. This must be a rare glimpse into the whirling fire Yuri keeps concealed inside her head. Suddenly she's finished. Everyone is stunned. Yuri snaps back to reality and glances around her, as if she bewildered even herself. It's up to me to save this situation. I'm the first to start applauding. Everyone joins me afterward, and we get Yuri the recognition she deserves. It's not that we didn't want to applaud for her, but we were so caught off guard that we must have forgotten. As we applaud, Yuri holds the poem to her chest and rushes back to her seat.
Yuri, that was really good. Thank you for sharing.
Yuri looks down. Yuri... Looks like Yuri is down for the count.
Okay. I guess I'm next then.
Sayori hops out of her chair and cheerfully walks to the podium.
This one is called My Meadow. Sorry, I giggled.
Sayori?
It's a lot harder than I thought. How'd you guys do it so easily? Try not to think of it like you're reciting it to other people. Imagine you're reciting it to yourself, like in front of a mirror or in your own head. It's your poem, so it'll come out the best that way. I see. Okay then.
Sayori begins her poem. Somehow it feels like her soft voice was made as a perfect match. The poem isn't aimlessly cheery like Sayori is.
It's serene and bittersweet. If I were to read this poem, or if I were to read this on paper, I probably wouldn't think much of it. But hearing it come from Sayori's voice almost gives it a whole new meaning. Maybe this is what Sayori meant when she said she likes my poems. It's like I get to reach more deeply into someone than I thought I knew. Through and through. Sayori finishes, and we applaud.
I did it!
Good job, Sayori.
Even SN liked it. I guess that's a good sign.
What does that even mean?
Came out nicely, Sayori. The atmosphere of the poem fits you really nicely. But it might be that other poems didn't quite work as well with that kind of delivery. I don't really understand. In other words, I've seen poems of yours where that sort of gentle delivery wouldn't work as well. They might need a little more force behind them, depending on what you're reading. Oh, I know what you mean. I've been practicing that kind of thing. It's just embarrassing to do in front of everyone. But then next time, I'm gonna make you pick a poem that challenges you a little more. We don't have much time before the festival, you know. Okay. Now, who's next? Natsuki. Don't make me go before SN. It's not like I can compare to you guys anyway. Might as well let SN lower everyone's standards a little before I have to do it. Natsuki!
It's fine. I might as well get it over with. But it's not like I have much of a selection of what to read. I'll just have to go with what I wrote for today. I stand up and step in front of the podium. Everyone has their eyes on me, making me feel terribly awkward. I recite my poem. Since I'm not exactly confident in my own writing, it's hard to put energy into it. Despite that, once I finish, I receive applause anyway. Sorry, I'm not really as good as everyone else.
Don't worry about it so much. I think it's less about your abilities and more about your lack of confidence in your writing. It's something that'll improve over time, though.
Yeah, maybe.
Alright then. That just leaves you, Natsuki. Yeah. I'm going.
Natsuki begrudgingly gets out of her seat, makes her way to the podium.
This poem is called... Why are you all looking at me? Because you're presenting. Anyway, this poem is called Jump.
Natsuki takes a breath. Once she starts reciting the poem, her sour attitude disappears a little. While she's still a little unenthused, her poem has a rhythm and a rhyme to it. It's Natsuki's trademark style, and it works surprisingly well when spoken aloud. The words feel like they bounce up and down, as if given life to the poem. Natsuki finishes, and everyone applauds. She huffs back to her seat.
That wasn't so bad, was it? Easy for you to say. You better not make me do that again. Well, do you at least feel prepared to recite your poem in front of other people? I mean, doing it in front of other people will be way easier. I can put on whatever face I want for other people. But when it's just my friends, it's just embarrassing. It's a surprise, Natsuki. I would think it would be the other way around, for me. Well, that's just how it is, so... Well, I guess in that case, you won't have much to worry about for the festival. That said, I want to thank everyone for coming through. It might be hard, but I hope that you all have an idea of what it's like now. Make sure you pick a poem and get enough practice before the festival, okay? I'll be making pamphlets, so let me know ahead of time what you'll be reciting.
Jeez. I should probably find some other poem to recite instead.
That's fine too. Doesn't have to be one. It doesn't have to be your own. I'm already pleasantly surprised that you're putting in all this effort for the club. Makes me really happy.
Yeah, no problem.
Okay, everyone. I think that's about it for today. I know the festival's coming up, but let's try to write poems for tomorrow as well. It's been working out really nicely so far, so I'd like to continue that. As for the festival, we finish planning tomorrow, and we'll have to weekend to prepare. Monday's a big day. Can't wait. I can do this. I can do this.
All right. Now stand up. There is no way I'll be able to find the same enthusiasm as Sayori and Monika, but I'll do my best to get through it.
If it's for the sake of the club
and impressing Monika, then I'll have to do my best. Are you ready to go, Sayori?
Yep. You two, always going home together like that. It's kind of adorable, isn't it?
Jeez, guys. Don't make such a big deal out of it.
It must be a nice, a little nice, though.
Well, how am I supposed to respond to that?
It's okay. You don't have to say it.
Whatever. Let's go already. I walk home with Sayori once more. Even though it's only been a few days, and a lot of things have already changed. But today, Sayori's being a little quieter than usual on the way home. Hey, Sayori.
Sorry, was I spacing out?
No wonder.
I was thinking about something from earlier. Like, I like how we get to... I mean...
Sayori fumbles with her words.
So, let's just say that one day, Yuri asked to walk home with you.
Huh?
What would you do?
What kind of question is that? You kind of put me on the spot here. I mean, Yuri's nice and all, but I would still walk home with Sayori, right? Sayori? You really think I would ditch you for Yuri?
But she's beautiful and smart.
Jeez. I already see her in club every day. Besides, you always seem to really like going home together. I wouldn't just ruin that for you.
You're so silly, Asen. Think about me too much sometimes. Yuri would deserve it if she wanted it. So...
Sayori, I've already made up my mind. I really can't figure you out sometimes.
Sorry.
Besides, what's the point of speculating something that's never going to happen? Conversation trails off. It's kind of a weird thing for Sayori to care so much about. But I want to respect her and keep her happy too. And again, the festival's only a few days away. Who knows what'll happen in that time? Okay, going to save before making this. And yeah, we're going to basically start from this new poem next week. So yeah, we didn't get to the game being weird yet. So I guess this is at least the pleasant part of the game, because I know the game does get weird eventually. But, you know, if at some point we could just be like, oh, no, it's just fine. It's fine. Just remember when it was weird. Okay, empty slot. Yeah, let's go ahead and wrap it up there. Yeah. I want to thank folks for watching. I do appreciate it. Especially putting up with the one girl voice that I have and my quickly labored voice that I'm just using. But yeah, I want to thank folks for watching. I do appreciate it. I want to give a shout out to the folks watching the VOD, whether it be on Twitch or over on the YouTube archive. I do hope you enjoy the stream that you are able to catch live at some point. Follow the channel, like, join the Discord if you want. Both are great ways to keep track of when I do come online. Get subbed to the channel here on Twitch. Helps keep the lights on, helps keep me in video games, super supportive, all that good stuff. Over on YouTube, like the video, comment, let me know if you're enjoying it so far. Like, I know the game hasn't gotten weird yet, so it's just nice, poem making simulator thing. We had a few awkward experiences with Sayori. You know, that was fun, right? I don't know. Like, comment, subscribe, do all the YouTube things. Here helps. I don't even know. Next scheduled stream is Tuesday, but I'm kind of considering maybe throwing another stream in, either bringing back Sunday or Monday, because with all of the dead spaces, I kind of want to bring in another stream to try to get through the series a little quicker over the course of the month, especially since Rito was generous to gift me the third game, and we're not even through the first game yet, so yeah. I'm considering throwing another stream in, probably bringing back the Monday late night streams. I'll have to see how I'm feeling about it a little closer, but yeah. Anyway, I do hope everybody's taking care of themselves with everything going on. I have been Somebody Nowhere. You have been amazing, and I do hope to see you next time. Sure to get lucky. Game did not go all crazy. But yeah. Have a good night. See you soon.